Haribo, and welcome to Lesson 17 of Basic Mridanga Instruction. Today I'm going to teach you a new variation on Three Tala Mantras. So Three Tala Mantra is kind of a term of my own invention. I coined the term basically to describe any kind of mantra that has significant repetitions of three. One, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. So a lot of mantras that we've learned before have beats that number, for example, 6, 12, 24, and so forth. Different multiples of three, and we're going to focus on a simple but newer, a little more complex variation of one of the simple ones we learned before. So the simple one we learned before was da ke ta ke, okay, and then it goes on like that. I'm going to demonstrate it for you. Okay, so this mantra has this repetitious da da. So we're going to learn a little more complex variety of this, but it's also a mantra that's quite exciting. These Three Tala Mantras are used in usually the end cycle of a kirtan, where they're kind of everybody's leaping and excitedly chanting the mantras, or sometimes they're even used throughout a bhajan in a more relaxed manner to give a more upbeat feel. And a lot of the different terminology for these mantras are, for example, Chaitala or Ektala. And there are mantras, I kind of classify them all together as Three Tala Mantras because they're all multiples of three with a significant downbeat on every third beat. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, like that. So the mantra we'll learn today is as follows. De kati ka ti. Kati ka ti, kati ka ti, da ti da. Okay, that's it. Now, there are three major patterns in this mantra. One of them is repeated. So the first pattern is de kati ka. And it's fairly simple, and I'll go into it in a minute. The second pattern is ti kati ka, and it's repeated twice. This is the middle pattern. So it's de kati ka, ti kati ka, ti kati ka. And then the last pattern, ti da ti da. So let's go through it step by step. First pattern is de kati ka. So it goes de, which is ge and ti together, ka, ke and ta together, de ka, and then ti by itself, and then ka again, ke and ta. So this is probably the most complex, difficult part of this entire mantra, because you're going from de to ka, which is closed on the left, open on the left, closed on the right, to closed on the left and open on the right. You're kind of alternating the two, but once you get this down, it's very simple. De ka ti ka, okay? That's the first pattern. De ka ti ka. Okay? The second pattern is ti ka ti ka. It's a closed kind of quiet pattern. Ka, ti, ka, okay? So that's repeated. Ti, ka, ti, ka. Of course, it's in rhythm. So the first ti is extended, just like the first de in the first pattern. Ti, ka, ti, ka, ti, ka, ti, ka. Okay? And that's played twice. So it's de, ka, ti, ka, ti, ka, ti, ka, ti, ka, ti, ka. Okay? Last pattern is ti, da, ti, da. Ti, then they're both open, da. Ti, da, ti, da. Ti, da, ti, da. Okay? The whole thing together, just I'll play one cycle, goes like this. Okay? De, ka, ti, ka. Ti, ka, ti, ka. Ti, ka, ti, ka. Ti, da, ti, da. Now I'm going to play a few cycles of this. We'll start at a moderate pace, not a very slow pace, a moderate pace, and then we'll go a little bit faster, and then I'll demonstrate how to play it in a kirtan. So let's get started. De ka ti ka, ti ka ti ka, ti ka ti ka, ti ka ti ka, de ka ti ka, ti ka ti ka. Thank you. see that this has a repetitive pattern in the right hand, which is ti ta ti ta ti ta ti ta. So on the right hand, the entire time it's the same way. So you can latch onto this rhythm here as the constant in this mantra. Though all the variety comes from the left hand. So it has a much more variety. Ti ta ti ta ti ta ti ta is your constant. Again, to review, this mantra is ti ta 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 ti ta. Now, I'm going to sing a little bit of kirtan, and you can see how it's played in a kirtan, and follow along a little bit. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Okay. That's a little bit of taste. Now, I'm going to show you the subdivided mantras of this. So, as in the three talas we've learned before, this mantra has two varieties that are shorter than the full 24-beat cycle. So, if you combine pattern 1 with pattern 3, the ending pattern, and just do that, this now is a full mantra. Dhe kati kati dhati dha, dhe kati kati dhati dha. So, we just skip the middle two patterns. Dhe kati ka is the original starting pattern. And then ti dha ti dha. So it goes like this. De ka ti ka ti dha ti dha. De ka ti ka ti dha ti dha. Again. De ka ti ka ti dha ti dha. De ka ti ka ti dha ti dha. And then even shorter variety is if you just play pattern number 3. Ti da ti da, ti da ti da, ti da ti da. Which goes like this. Quite simple. So I'm going to show you a little bit of kirtan and practice that incorporates both of these half and quarter styles. Nitai Gaur Hari Bo. So, these mantras can be used kind of interchangeably depending on how you want to drive the kirtan. The half beat and the quarter beat, of course, have more heavy down beats with the heavy ge hits. So it's up to you on how you want to. If you want the kirtan to more, sound a little bit more light, use the full cycle. Okay. And then if you want it to be more heavy, you use the half cycle and the quarter cycle. Now, there is one more variation you can add to this to make it sound a little bit better, and that's to double up the hits, just as in the previous mantras that we've learned. So in the previous one, it was more like so the same principle applies here. The mantra sounds like this. De ka ti ka ti ka ka ti ka ti ke ka ti ka. Sorry, it's ti ke ka ti ka. So and I'm going to go over this a little more slowly, but let's go through the whole thing. De ka ti ka ti ke ka ti ka ti ke ka ti ka ti ge da ti da. So we're adding a stroke in the rest that's after that first beat in each pattern. So we leave pattern one untouched, de ka ti ka, but then pattern two is ti ke ka ti ka. So we had a rest between ti and ka before, ti ka. Now we have ti ke ka ti ka. Instead of ti ka ti ka, ti ke ka ti ka, ti ke ka ti ka, ti ke ka ti ka. Okay? The same thing goes in the last pattern, ti ge da ti da. Before we had ti da ti da. Now it's ti ge da ti da. Ti ge da ti da. Okay? So I'm going to demonstrate this whole cycle for you a couple of times. De ka ti ka, ti ke ka ti ka, ti ke ka ti ka. So let's follow along. Faster, it's even more nice and lively. Okay, so that's a little bit of a more complex variety, but still simple, of the three talas. And you can use this to add a little bit more variety in your kirtan, add a little bit more excitement, and get more practice with using both hands. Especially this requires some coordination because you're using both hands alternately. So I'm going to leave you with just a little bit of demonstration of where you can go from here. I'm not going to go into detail on these mantras as usual. However, I'm just going to show you how you can build upon the basic mantra and add to it. It's a little bit of variety just to show you how you can go from here. But the basic mantra is De ka ti ka, ti ka ti ka, ti ka ti ka, ti ka ti ka. Or De ka ti ka, ti ke ka ti ka, ti ke ka ti ka, ti ke ka ti ka. There you have it. I hope this helps you and encourages you to play a little bit more variety and try to learn more about mridanga and play along in this with a wonderful kirtan. Thank you very much for your attention. Hare Krishna.